మా స్కూల్ సైన్స్ ఫెయిర్ కు లిమ్కా బుక్ ఆఫ్ రికార్డ్ సాధించింది.
నా పెద్ద మనవరాల్ని అన్ని వసతులతో క్వాలిటీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అందిస్తున్న స్కూల్లోనే జాయిన్ చేశాను.
ఏ స్కూల్ సార్ అది?
ఉల్లంపర్రి మాంటిసరీ స్కూల్. క్వాలిటీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ లో నెంబర్ 1, కల్చరల్ యాక్టివిటీస్ లో నెంబర్ 1, స్పోర్ట్స్ లో నెంబర్ 1, క్యాంపస్ లో నెంబర్ 1.
చదువులో, తెలివితేటల్లో, ఆలోచన విధానంలో, నాయకత్వ లక్షణాల్లో వారు ఏ రంగంలో ముందున్నారో గుర్తించి విజేతలుగా నిలపడమే ఉల్లంపర్రు మాంటిసోరీస్ ప్రత్యేకత. పాలకొండ పట్టణంలో ఉన్నత విద్యతో పాటు భవిష్యత్తులో బాగా సెటిల్ అవుతున్న వారిలో అత్యధికులు ఉల్లంపర్రు మాంటిసోరీస్ విద్యార్థులే.
ఇలా అన్ని ఉన్న చోట మన పిల్లల్ని చదివిస్తేనే వాళ్ళకి మంచి భవిష్యత్తు ఉంటుంది. ఇక నుండి ఏ పిఆర్ఓ చెప్పినా వినను, ఉల్లంపర్రు మాంటిసోరీస్ లోనే చదివిస్తాను.
మీ పిల్లల బంగారు భవిష్యత్తుకు మాది బాధ్యత.
అడ్మిషన్ల కొరకు సంప్రదించండి మాంటిసోరీస్ విద్యా సంస్థలు ఉల్లంపర్రు. ఫోన్ 222206. బ్రాంచెస్ రామారావుపేట ఫోన్ 224200. కొడిగట్టు ఫోన్ 228800.
గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ స్టూడెంట్స్, దిస్ ఇస్ అనంత, ద టీచర్ ఆఫ్ మాంటిసోరీస్. టుడే ఐ యామ్ గోయింగ్ టు డీల్ విత్ లెసన్ ఫుడ్ సెక్యూరిటీ ఆఫ్ 10th క్లాస్ పేపర్ 1. ఇన్ టుడేస్ లెసన్ you are going to learn about the mainly three aspects. They are the role of government in ensuring the food security to the people through these ways. They are issue of food production and the availability of food grains, access to food, another one is checking the nutrition status of the people. So these are the basic concepts of this lesson. First of all, let us learn about food. Why do we need food? Food is our basic need. We need food for energy. Through energy, we can work well, we fight with the diseases, we remain healthy. So we need food. Here it is mentioned about the Bengal famine of India in the year 1943 and 45. So do you know what happened in Bengal during this period? There are 3 to 5 million starvation deaths happened because of severe famine in and around the Bengal, like Bengal, Assam and Odisha. So in Bengal, people have suffered with inadequate food. This led to the starvation of deaths. So do you know, in pre-independent India, mainly before our colonial rule, so rulers did not concentrate on the supply of food grains. That's why famine situations are common to India, which led to the starvation deaths. So once we got our independence, our newly formed government has a task before that. Main goal of our government was to provide food security to the people. Through some ways, it has achieved its progress in providing the food security, but still there are some limitations also there. So let me explain you clearly about this. So first, what is the role of government in providing the food security? The first method, first system I have mentioned here is issue of food production and the availability of food grains to the people. So how is it possible? Providing food security is mainly possible only through increasing the food production. It means what? To the required quantity, that is for the population of India, it is the main task to provide the sufficient food grains. So to concentrate on this, the first step has taken by the government is issue of food production. That is, if government is supporting the farmers in producing more and more food grains, automatically it can increase the production levels. It can increase the food grains production. So that's why it has taken some steps to increase the production level. So do you know, here I am showing you two graphs to you. So one graph is these four, that is right from 1971 to 2011. So what changes did you observe here? There is rapid increase in the paddy, wheat and oil seeds production. But whereas coming to jowar did not progress as like these three. But if you observe another graph also here, it is telling about the per hectare yield of a crop. Per hectare yield means what? The area under cultivation is not increased over the years. There is a little bit change only there here. So, but production levels has increased rapidly. Why? What are the reasons? So the second graph is revealing the per hectare yield of a crop. Okay? So see, how does it possible? First one is providing necessary inputs. In a given hectare of the land, in the given area, to increase production levels, if we provide the necessary inputs, definitely it can increase the production level. So that is what providing the necessary inputs, that too in a judicial manner. That means whatever is required, like that it should be provided to the land. So the first one is telling that providing necessary inputs in a judicial manner. The second one is expansion of irrigation facilities, and it is also one of the important tasks taken by the government is the expansion of irrigation facilities, because earlier farmers used to grow the crops only once in a year. They have depended completely on the rainfall. So that was also one of the reasons for the shortage of food grains to the increased population. So to solve this problem, the main task in front of the government is increase the irrigation facilities. Then government started construction of the dams, watershed development programs. Like that, it started expanding the irrigation facilities. But here, one of the important note we have to remember that in using water for irrigation also must we go in a judicial manner. Why? Because water is a common pool to everyone. So everyone has the right to make use of the water. So equitable manner of using water is necessary in irrigation facilities also. The next one is growing crops as per the local conditions. So do you know all the regions do not receive the same range of rainfall? That means what? The range of rainfall is not uniform in all the places. Some places receive more rainfall whereas others receive low rainfall and no rainfall also. So if you take Rayalaseema region in Andhra Pradesh, so this is a place which receives very less rainfall. Like that, if you take desert area receives very low rainfall and no rainfall also. So like that, depending on the local conditions, crops should be grown. So in drought areas, drought resistant crops should be grown. So here, if you take low rainfall regions, water resistant crops are to be encouraged. The crops which requires low rainfall or low water. So if you take our coastal regions, paddy is a staple food in our coastal regions because abundant water supply, alluvial soils are suitable for growing the paddy because of moderate temperature levels here. But if you take Rayalaseema, it's a drought prone region which is suitable for growing groundnut. So groundnut is a crop which requires less water. So like that, in the areas which receive low rainfall means water resistant crops should be grown in those areas. So these three are important in issuing the food production. Then next one is availability of food. Next topic is the availability of food grains. First, before this, we have learned about the issue of food production by the government. Then, coming to this availability of food grains, here we have to see the two aspects. Availability of food grains for the year, that is total availability of food grains in a year to the people, that is can be obtained by doing this. Production of food grains during the year plus net imports minus change in stocks with the government. So I am going to explain clearly about this. Production of food grains during the year refers to total production minus seed, feed and wastage. So by doing this you will get production of food grains during the year. The second one is net imports refers to imports minus exports. The last one is change in stocks with the government refers to, it is about the closing stock at the end of the year minus the opening stock at the beginning of the year. So this is comes under the change in stocks with the government. So by doing this, what did we get? We get availability of food grains for the year. Then availability of food grains per person a day. It is also, we say that per capita availability of food grains to a person in a day. That is, so first we have obtained here availability of food grains for the year. So that we have to use here. Availability of food grains for the year divided by population. By doing this, we have to divide it by 365 days. So by doing this, we will get availability of food grains per person a day. So using these two, next we are going to estimate the nutrition status of a person. What falls under food grains? Food grains category, edible oils, cereals and pulses, all these comes under the food grains category. So edible oils are cooking oils like sunflower oil, palm oil, groundnut oil. So extracting oils from oil seeds, so growing oil seeds also one of the important crop which comes under the food grains category only. Then cereals, coming to the cereals category, there are fine cereals and coarse cereals. Fine cereals refers to barley and wheat. Coarse cereals refers to jowar, ragi, millets, etc. So why do we have this difference here? Mainly, most of the people eat paddy and wheat where these crops are grown well, mainly in the coastal regions. So wheat, it's the crop of the North India where those climatic conditions are suitable for growing more wheat. But South India, the staple food is the paddy, as our soil conditions and climatic conditions are suitable for growing the paddy. So like that, because of extensive growing of these two crops made it fine cereals. We all believe that fine cereals are good, but it is true that coarse cereals like jowar, ragi, millets, they are high in the nutritious value. They are highly nutritious. But however, we are preferring paddy is the main food in our areas. So those coarse cereals are the staple food items in the areas where they grow, mainly in the Rayalaseema region, because they are the water resistant crops. In Rayalaseema, as it is a dry land region, it is a drought prone area. To those soil conditions, this crops, coarse cereals are well grown. So to those people, those coarse cereals are the staple food. Then the next two, availability of the food is access to food. It is very important task of the government to assess the food. It refers to the ensuring the food availability by each and every person or public. So through various schemes and systems, government is providing the food security and making the people to make use of this available food grains. So here there is a standard which is telling the nutrition status also of every individual. Here an important note is to be understood that over the years the production has increased a lot. The per hectare yield crop is increasing. Even though the production levels are increased, the per capita availability of food to an individual is insufficient. So how does it relate to that? Though the production is more, the food taken by each and every individual is less over the years. So to solve this problem, government is focusing on the access to food. So there is a standard which is revealing the kilocalories to urban and rural individual. So why do we take the food? We take the food for energy, growth, to remain healthy and to fight illness. So the food we consume into our body, it will burn up and changes into heat. As it produces the heat, which in turn is measured as the calories. So the availability of food and the food we take is measured in terms of the kilocalories. So through food, what are the energy we are consuming, we are getting? So it is as it is measured in the kilocalories. So as per a standard, it is stated that to an urban individual needs 2100 kilocalories of food per day. The same way, rural individuals involved in more manual work, they have to take 2400 kilocalories per day. So do you know this is per day? Okay, but what is happening now? As per the present levels, though the production levels are more, a marginal individual is taking very less food as compared to the prescribed one. That is only just 1643 like that. So here it is very less to a rural individual as the prescribed one is 2400 kilocalories. But why? What is the reason? The main reason is that lack of purchasing power. If the people have adequate purchasing power, they are able to take diverse food items. But coming to rural communities or urban communities, if an individual have less purchasing power, as they have the less income, they are unable to consume more and more. So this is a reason behind taking the less calories of food. Then how does the food is distributed among the people? So government has implemented some schemes. So as a part of that, public distribution system is playing a vital role. Public distribution system. So through ration shops are also called as fair price shops. Through ration shops, government is providing the food grains to the people at low cost. So we can say that by subsidized price. So the actual cost is going to bear by the government, but it is offering to the people at low cost, that we call as the subsidized price. So do you know every year what are the total production of food grains are there in our country? So 1/3 of food grains is taken from the farmers by the government by giving the minimum support price to the farmers. So do you know 1/3 of production is taken by the government on the name of buffer stock. It maintains the stock of food grains. That is 1/3 of food grains are collected from the farmers. So through FCI, Food Corporation of India. FCI refers to, what is the full form of FCI? Food Corporation of India. So through Food Corporation of India, it maintains the buffer stock of the food grains, and those food grains will be distributed to public through ration shops or fair price shops. Then the next one is through Anganwadis. So Anganwadis are the centers which take care of the young children. So they take care of the young children by providing the nutritious food to the children, mainly 5 years of age children, 1 to 5 years of age children. They are taking the less food which can affect their nutrition levels also, their growth also. So to solve this problem, so Anganwadis are providing the nutritious food. Then midday meals program. So this midday meals program was first started in the Tamil Nadu. Then as it was the instruction given by the central government to follow in each and every state of India. Now it is very effectively implementing in all the states of India. So through that, the children of the age 6 to 16 years, so they have the provision of availability of meals in our schools. So which in turn helps the government to increase the educational levels of the people also. So like that, midday meals program, then there was an act introduced in the year 2013, that is National Food Security Act. So our government came out with the National Food Security Act in 2013 for implementing this food security to the people in an effective and efficient manner. So under this, it also works well, that is for the child development. Yes, I have already mentioned here about the midday meals and Anganwadis. For efficient work of Anganwadis and schools in providing the midday meals. So under the scheme implemented by the government, that is Integrated Child Development Scheme, ICDS. The full form of ICDS is Integrated Child Development Scheme. The third one is nutrition status. The food we consume consists of proteins, vitamins, fats, minerals and carbohydrates. So if you take the balanced diet, we remain healthy. So depending upon this, a survey was conducted on the nutrition status of the people by National Institute of Nutrition. It is at Hyderabad. The NIN survey conducted is revealed that 45% of children of the age 1 to 5 years, below 5 years category, or comes under the stage of underweight. That means it is telling that they are taking less food. So this nutrition status is to be measured in terms of body mass index, BMI. So generally, coming to the children age, how do we measure their healthiness? Their healthiness can be measured in terms of their height, weight and age. So depending upon this, we can say their healthiness. So like that, how do we calculate the body mass index of an adult or a child? That is by weight in kgs by height in meter square. So by doing this, we get the BMI, that is body mass index. So I am going to conclude the topic that a careful planning of food security is necessary by the government to enable the public to make use of the government services. So here there are some questions related to this topic, food security. So one more questions. Sometimes you will get the full farms PDS, public distribution system, MSP, minimum support price, NIN, National Institute of Nutrition. It is located at Hyderabad. Then BMI, body mass index, the fair price shops refers to ration shops. Then Anganwadi centers. So as we know that Anganwadi centers are the centers which helps the children of 1 to 6 years, and they are providing the food security by providing the nutritious food to them. Then coming to two marks questions are on the work of ration shops. As we know that government is issuing the cards to the public depending upon their income levels. So low income groups are entitled to get 5 kgs of food grains to a person. So like that, there are some special cards also there. They are called Antyodaya cards. So to the poorest of the poor, so first I have told you that low income groups are entitled to get 5 kgs of food grains. But whereas Antyodaya card holders, who are Antyodaya card holders? They are the poorest of the poor category. So they are entitled to get 35 kgs of food grains per a month. So they are the Antyodaya card holders. So like that, government is ensuring the food security to the people, but in the working of ration shops we can find that some members are cheating the people in weighing the goods, and they are not extending the time as given by the government also, and some goods are sending to black markets. Like that, if careful planning and checking of these malpractices to be done to ensure the food security to the people. So like that, work of ration shops, we will get this question in different ways. As this work of ration shops is going on properly or not. So like that, if it is asked in twisted way also, you are able to answer this question. Then 4 marks questions. Classification of food. I have already told you that we have to take the diverse food items. The food which includes carbohydrates, vitamins, minerals, fats, like that. Classification of food, and why do we require the food also. So we take the food to remain healthy, for growth, to fight illness. So like that, all together, by adding all these points, we will get a single question about the classification of food and why do we require the food. Then select features of food security bill. So this question refers to the National Food Security Act taken by the government in the year 2013. That is the work of the Anganwadis, fair price shops. Then government also focusing on the providing nutritious food to the pregnant women, lacting women. Like that, it is giving importance to the health status of the people. So like that, all this comes under the food security bill. So in this, availability of the food, access to food, nutrition status also, a careful planning is to be required. A present problem is that diversification of the crops. Diversification of crops means farmer is able to grow different types of crops to earn more income. To get more income, he is shifting from food grains to cash crops. So what happens if he is continuing the same on large scale? It will be a threat to the food grains. The production of food grains will be lessened if more preference is given to the cash crops. So do you know, already India is in a position that the per capita availability of the food to a person is very less as compared to European countries. person is only 463 kilocalories. Do you know India's per capita availability is very less as compared to other countries of the world? Only India's per capita availability is only 463 grams, whereas European countries have 700 grams and US, United States of America has 850 grams. So by this comparison, we can understand that it is necessary or it is a responsibility of the government to work on this one to increase the food security to the people. Thank you.
Ullampur Montessori School, అది డిజీ క్లాసులు, ఇది ఐఐటి క్లాసులు సమర్థవంతంగా నిర్వహిస్తున్నారు. ఈ స్కూల్ నుండి 10 మంది డాక్టర్లు, 8 మంది చార్టర్డ్ అకౌంటెంట్లు, అనేక మంది ఐఐటి ఎన్ఐటిలో చదివిన ఇంజనీర్లు ఉన్నారు. అంతేకాదు ఈ విద్యా సంస్థల్లో 10 రకాల కాంపిటేషన్ ఎగ్జామ్స్లోని విజయకేతలు ఎగరేశారు. 4 స్టేట్ ఫస్ట్లు, 40 టాప్ 10 ర్యాంకులతో పాటు 13 మంది గోల్డ్ మెడల్ సాధించారు. ఒత్తిడి లేని విద్యను అందిస్తూ అటు జాతీయ స్థాయి స్పోర్ట్స్ ర్యాంకులతో పాటు ఇటు ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ర్యాంకులు సాధిస్తున్న ఏకైక విద్యా సంస్థ ఉల్లంపూర్ మాంటిసోరి స్కూల్.